you like to go out? Yes. Only to play or to walk also?
Yes. Walk, cycle, enjoy the place.
Enjoy what? Enjoy the place. Okay. So today we are going to do something new, something different, and that is we are going to make a word pair. Have you made a word pair earlier?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So then it's easy for you. I'm writing nature. You have to tell me words which come to your mind instantly when I say the word nature. Yes.
Trees.
Okay, let me make a tree too. Yes, ready.
Greenery.
Yes, sir, were you saying something?
Soil.
Soil. Yes, Nikita.
Peace.
Peace. Wow. This clap for her. Lovely word. Peace. Yes, Amrit.
Scenery.
Scenery. Yes.
Animals.
Animals. How many of you like animals? How many of you got pets at home? How many of you take care of nature? How many of you litter? How many of you cut trees? Pluck flowers? Nobody? All very good children. Yes, Yushika?
Mom, fresh air.
Freshness, okay. Can I write freshness for you? Freshness. Yes. Sun. One more. I can definitely find. Yes, Linda.
Forest.
Forest. Okay, that's it. So many words. When we think of nature, there are so many words which encompasses the nature. And before I go on, I want to close your eyes. All of you will close your eyes. Do you like to listen to poems?
Yes, ma'am.
All of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then you have to listen to the poem which I'm going to recite just now. Read it for you. Eyes closed by. I wandered lonely as a cloud. Yes, child. Is Veda Shirish Patel here in this class? No, no, child. Thank you. Sorry, keep your eyes closed. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze, continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way. They stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. Waves beside them danced, but they outdid the sparkling waves and clay. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. I gazed and gazed, but little thought what wealth the show to me had brought. For aught when on my couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive mood, the crash upon that inward eye, which is the bliss of solitude. And then my heart with pleasure fills and dances with the dance. Please open your eyes. Yes. This poem, the name of this poem is
Happiness.
And it is written by William Wordsworth. Have you heard this poem? No, no. Okay. So we will be giving you a video link. You must listen it and see the host of golden daffodils. So to begin with, I wandered lonely as a cloud. Who is wandering lonely as a cloud?
I'm a man.
one's birth? Did you go on the journey with the daffodils or were you here? How many of you were here? All the transfers. Did I read so well?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Thank you. I take a pack. Now, how many of you were transferred to the host of Golden Daffodil? Vineet, Renee? Oh, all of you. So tell me your feelings. Let's hear your feelings before I go on to explain. Yes. You felt excited. Seeing what? The daffodils. Were you able to imagine the daffodils? Visualize? Oh, that's good. Okay, you are feeling cheerful and happy. So you, did you see the daffodils crossing their heads or did you see it dancing? What did you see?
Crossing
their heads. Okay. Yes, Tuka. Are you able to hear her? No, you have to be loud, right?
I was feeling pleasure.
You were feeling the pleasure. Okay. Pleasure of seeing what?
The daffodils.
The daffodils.
I was feeling peace.
Peace. You were feeling peaceful. Very good.
I was feeling happy.
You were feeling happy.
Fresh.
You felt freshness in your stomach, tummy. So you felt fresh. Fresh within. Okay, that's a wonderful thing. And what happened to your leg? Hairline crack. How did you manage to get it? Continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way. They stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. So they were like continuous stars. There were so many of them that it looked like the stars twinkling in the
Milky Way.
They stretched in never-ending line. So the line seemed to be
never-ending.
And it was loud dappers. And they were doing a sprightly dance.
Sprightly dance.
So how do you know what a sprightly dance is? Yeah? Yes?
Lively
dance. They were doing a lively dance. The waves beside them danced. But, this is a very important line. But they outdid the sparkling waves and green. So, the waves were also dancing. But the daffodils were better than the waves. The waves were sparkling with the sunshine. But the daffodils were dancing
better.
A poet could not but be gay in such a joking company. So when you go out and walk in the nature, everything is peaceful, light breeze blowing. You feel so comforting. Isn't it? You feel calm. Like he rightly said, he forgot all his problems, all his tiredness, and he could enjoy the poem. He could enjoy the nature. Am I right, children?
Yes, ma'am.
I gazed and gazed, but little thought what wealth the shore to me had brought. So, the poet is thinking, what is the wealth which I am going to get from these daffodils? He did not even think that way. He just looked at the daffodils dancing. He enjoyed their company and then goes back home. Now the poet is saying, for oft when on my couch I lie. That time he didn't think, what is the wealth? Wealth doesn't mean over here gold and silver. Wealth is the wealth of memory. Okay? So, for oft when on my couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive way, they flash upon that inward eye. What is the inward eye? Yes?
Our imagination,
our thoughts, our memory. So, they flash upon that inward eye, which is a bliss of solitude. So the moment the poet starts thinking about those golden daffodils, the poet feels a different kind of pleasure. There is a bliss of
solitude.
And then my heart with pleasure fills and dances with the daffodils. So when the poet is sad and he thinks about the daffodils, he feels happy and pleasure fills in his heart. And he enjoys that moment. So many a time when we are in the nature, we are walking, we are seeing colourful flowers and all. We don't ever think, you know, what is it that you're going to remember. How many of you have gone to the hill stations? When you come back home, do you remember the hills? The snow. Do you remember the snow? The steep roadway. The trees growing on both the sides. Do you remember those things when you come here? Sometimes you're tired. You think about that.
Yes,
and when you think about that, that does it give you happiness?
Yes, ma'am.
Gives you happiness?
Yes.
How many of you feel happy when you think about the chocolate? How many of you feel happy when you think about a pizza? How many of you feel happy when you think about maths? How many of you feel happy when you think about geography? How many of you feel happy when you think about Kirana? Yeah. How many of you? All of you feel happy? Can I take period after period with you? Then you feel happy
still?
Okay. So everything which gives us happiness, when you think about it, you really feel happy. Don't we?
Yes.
Now please take out your book and let's read it aloud together. Let's read it aloud. We'll read it aloud. It is page 14. Page 14. Ready? I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high oak vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils.
margin of a bay. 10,000 tons of salt and the lambs, tossing their heads, reached by the lambs. The waves beside them dance, but they outdid the sparkling waves in green. A poet could not run away in such a jovial company. I gazed and gazed a little thought, what wealth the stone to me had brought. For often on my couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive mood. It flashed upon that inward eye, which is the visit of the good. And then my heart with pleasure fills, and dances with their happiness.
You enjoy reading the book?
Yes, ma'am.
All of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now in your notebook, children, you are going to create your own word pair or nature. The first thing. The second thing we will do just now is the KWL sheet. How many of you have done it in standard 5? You've done it. Raise your hands up. What does K stand for? Pack your bags.